Ran out of water.
The fog here is just incredibly insane.
We left you guys last week way up here in this little cove off of Pick Island. We take off through the pea soup of fog, make it over to the Slate Islands, which is quite a bit treacherous, and then up to this sweet little town of Rossport where we finally get to resupply, see some other humans, and then we're gonna bebop around some of these great islands and check out some of the harbors and lakes that they have. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching.
I believe only in love. Everything else on earth lacks meaning. Even if this world is leveled to the ground. Even if
ran out of water.
Thank you, God, for the fresh lake.
It's one of the benefits of sailing the Great Lakes. Refilling our tanks. How many gallons does she hold?
About 100.
100?
100 gallons in 12 days, that's pretty good.
We just motor sailed all the way to the Slate Islands. It's been like pea soup the whole way, and this guy just popped up. So eerie. Crazy. Alright, I'll look out. My goodness. The fog here is just incredibly insane. I can't believe it. There's the island. Hands are so cold I couldn't get the button to record. We're in Pike's Bay in the Slate Islands. Quite a trek. This area is not well charted. And we came through up there. Not the channel you're seeing. Not that. But over here. Yeah, pretty gnarly. It was like three big, huge, unmarked rocks that we had to get around. My heart was racing, but we made it. I'm gonna go make myself some hot chocolate. It's so cold out. Okay, it's not that bad. It's just really foggy and damp. So it's a perfect time to cozy up. Got my tea. I got a good book. Kyle's out fishing. Oh, I'm excited. And by the way, I would love any book recommendations. Any ideas you have, send them my way, because I blow through books like crazy.
Not good.
Where are you going?
Nowhere.
It's a never-ending game. Cargo.
I think it's coming to an end.
Ooh, Chicago to Rochester?
Mm-hmm.
Might be interested. Board games and breakfast. We are sailing into Rossport. Pretty exciting. Ah! Rocket. Okay, it's really hard to tell in a video how dipped you are, but you can tell the snack is usually like way down here. I'm making lunch. But it's time to go to port because that's the last of my tomatoes. We need some veggie patties. Can't go wrong.
Ain't got nothing to say. Nothing to say. Breaking up, but I will never leave you. You swore that you need. Really, these ups and downs stick on you. I tell my hair. Cause again, you ain't got nothing to say. Cause again, you ain't got nothing to say. Ain't got nothing to say.
stacking up. Raw sport. There's our food to survive a week. And the jerry can for the gas. Because there's not actually gas in this arena. There you go. Well, folks, Kyle just made pizza on the boat.
Missy made it.
Pretty spectacular. And I got no photos or videos of the process because there was too much flour involved.
It's good.
And it's good. Stacked and loaded. About to leave this adorable little town of Rossport. Head back out to the islands. Highly recommend stopping here. It's just like this super cute little town. Not much going on, but this great little serendipity cafe. And Lauren, the guy that runs the dock, is amazing. He ran us around town all day today. Well then. Adios.
One way to do it.
Rossport. Even this marina the old-fashioned way. Fancy paddle you got there.
It's a really healthy looking lake. For my limited knowledge, but
there's like a major rapid. We are currently on a lake, on an island, in a lake. I just think that's so cool. Kyle's catching dinner. And we're live.
Live. Fishing sailing.
Right, we left Moore Harbor. We're on our way to Woodbine Harbor. Right? That's where we're going? Woodbine Harbor?
Yeah.
Because the book has a moose swimming in there, and I'm pretty convinced he's still swimming. In Woodbine Harbor.
Chain hook to be able to distribute the load amongst two cleats on the boat.
It's the hook we currently use, but a different...
Different way to support it. I think it'll minimize chafing and be stronger.
It's my goal in life. Minimize chafing. Is it long enough?
It's the longest I had. And it's going to be right there. If I splice the loops on it, good. Those hooks where we know it's perfectly even, it's like you have to deploy it and then leave the other one off at like the appropriate temperature. Hold it plain. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, it's a little without that loop. I wanted a couple feet below the water.
Looking through the woods with my dinghy. Just your everyday sailing portage paddle.